Hey guys, this is Rahul and you're welcome to gomahamaya.com, and in this tutorial we'll learn how to get secure padlock for your website for free, and you don't need to pay either single penny for this kind of work using sslforfree.com. Once you are on the sslforfree.com, there you'll find option to write your website. You just go there and type your website name. My name is www.gomahamaya.com, and there you'll find click on create SSL certificate. Click on that, and here you'll find three options: automatic, manual, manual verification DNS. So you click on manual verification, and in this method is like automatic FTP. You have to enter the FTP details. That will be like irritating for you, so it's better you go for manual version. And once you click on that, scroll down and you have to click on manual verify domain. This is the easiest method, and you have to scroll down. After that, you'll find there's one folder, say download file 1, download file 2. You have to click on both the file and open in a new tab, and both the files will be getting downloaded like this and this. Next, you have to go to your cPanel, and now once you are logging into cPanel, you have to scroll down and you have to find file manager. Click on that. Once you are inside the file manager, you will get various folders like this. You have to choose your domain. Basically, your domain will be inside public_html, but so many people have add-ons domain, so it will be like outside public_html, avidmedicare.com, you can see here. And for subdomain, you does not need SSL. It will be like automatic. If you're buying for domain, it will be for subdomain also. So click on public_html, and once you are public_html, you'll find WP admin, WP contain, WP includes, and like that the folders will be there, right? Once you are in this area, you have to click on setting and make sure click on show hidden file. This option is marked, and click on save. And now you'll see some of the hidden folders like .scss or some dot folders will be there, right? And now you click on folder option and write the name. Like before I write the name, I'll go to that page, that sslforfree.com. And there you'll find the name should be .well_unknown, right? Copy that name and paste here. Make sure you're having dot in the beginning, .well/known, and click on that create folder, and you'll find folder is getting created. Like click on that folder and again click on folder option, and again go back to the page, and next folder you need to create is Acme Challenge. Copy that name and go back to your cPanel again back and paste the name here. Click on create folder again, and now you can see the path is like public_html/well_known, and then inside well known it's Acme Challenge. You have created that folder, right? Now you click on that, and once you are inside Acme Challenge, you click on upload, and here you have to upload those two files that you downloaded just now. That one file was this, and it's got uploaded now, and number two file was this. Both the files you need to upload there, right? And again go back and refresh that cPanel page. Once you refresh the page, you'll find two files with the name similar to this, like whatever the last file name is there. If it is mismatched, in that case you won't get that verification, correct verification. So make sure name should be correct. And go back to title page again, that sslforfree.com, and click on the first one, and it will show you some data like this. And again you click on second one, and it will show you this verification data. If it does not, means you are getting error at this point, you have to rectify that. And next, once you are done, you have to click on download SSL certificate. Click on that, and here you'll get certificate successfully generated. You have to scroll down and you'll find your certificate here, and next you again scroll down, you'll find private key here, and again CA. You need to click on download all SSL files, and you'll see that SSL file got downloaded. Now work get divided for different cPanels. Like number one is Hostgator. They restricted SSL certificate. They charge $10 for adding SSL inside your website. And number two is cPanel, which have open SSL/TLS option. And here you have to click on your domain folder. Like my domain is inside public_HTML, so I'll click on that. And now you have to click on upload. And now here you have to select that file that you have just downloaded from sslforfree.com. You have to click on select and you have to choose this file and click on open, and it will get uploaded, and you have to click on go back. Now you can see that file is got uploaded. Now what you have to do, you have to go to hostgator.com and you have to raise a support ticket that I want to install SSL on my website, and you have to pay $10. And they are going to install that SSL for you. Other cPanel hosting companies are not charging either a single penny for this kind of work. You can proceed the video and see what kind of work they are going to do for you. And now, once you are inside your cPanel, you have to scroll down and you have to find SSL or TLS. Click on that. And next, you have to click on Manage SSL Sites. And now you have to scroll down, and there you have option to choose domain. Like whatever domain you have, it will be like selected. You have to select that domain. And next you have to scroll down and you have to Control A and Control C, copy the certificate and paste in the certificate area, and you'll get a success message. Again, go back and scroll down and click on that private key and Control A, Control C, and go back to the cPanel and scroll down, and you have to paste that private key. And next, go back again, click on CA bundle, Control A, Control C, and click on that cPanel and click on certificate authority bundle and click on paste there, and you have to click on install certificate, and then you'll get a success message. You have to click on OK, and now we'll move to a dashboard. Once you're logging into a cPanel, you have to scroll down and you'll find file manager. Click on that, and you have to scroll down and you have to choose your domain. Like my domain is inside public_HTML, so I'll click on that. Now click on SCSS file and click edit. And here you have to scroll down, and whatever code is there on the top, you don't have to worry about that, and you have to give enter and you have to paste the following code. And there you'll find you have options to write here your website name. Like mine is www.gomahamaya.com, so I'll edit that. And this code says that rewrite engine on, and rewrite rule is that whenever it says HTTP or something like that, redirect it to https://www.gomahamaya.com or whatever page is there. No issue about that. And this is a 301 permanent redirect. You have to click on save changes. And now we'll go back to our dashboard. And now once you are inside your dashboard, you have to hover over setting and you have to click on general, and there you'll find two options: WordPress address URL, you have to add S here, and in the site URL also you have to add S, and you will get secure mode. And once you are done, you have to click on save changes. And now we have to install one plugin for those people who are not getting secure in this area and secure in some of the pages. That has to be get fixed. So hover over plugin and click on add new, and in the search option you have to type SSL contained fixer. And in this area you'll get first option, SSL insecure contained fixer, and SAP 1 lakh plus active download. Click on activate, and once your plugin get activated, you'll get setting option. Click on that setting and fix insecure content, let it to be simple one, and you have to scroll down and you have will find fix specific plugins and themes. Choose this option and choose this option, and next scroll down, don't choose ignore external sites. You'll find HTTPS detection. You have to choose this option and standard WordPress function. And once you are done, you have to click on save changes. And now you'll 100% get secure in this area. If you could not, just visit once again your website and refresh the page, you'll get the secure text inside this green color icon. And if you still could not get that secure in the side option, you can comment below. I'll help you. Don't worry about that. I hope you find this video useful. If you have any question or query, let me know in the comment section. And don't forget to hit subscribe, because more WordPress tricks and techniques are coming on the way. Thank you.